right now, new developments in the Waukesha parade tragedy. What new court documents say about the attempt to stop the suspect who plowed through the crowd.
And when we could see a verdict in the Ahmaud Arbery case, a jogger killed in Georgia.
And of course, we are tracking the roadways, especially as folks begin to travel. We're going to have that in your first storm forecast.
Thanks for joining us, everyone. For News 3 Now this morning, I'm Chris Stanford.
And I'm Leah Lynchide. A $5 million bond and 5 charges of intentional homicide, with a 6th on the way for the suspect in the Waukesha parade killings.
39-year-old Daryl Brooks is facing life in prison this morning. This as a 6th victim has died from their injuries, an 8-year-old boy. Brooks made his first court appearance yesterday. New court documents filed as part of this appearance make it clear that police at the scene of the parade felt Brooks intentionally tried to hit as many people as possible. Ultimately, the court commissioner decided to grant him a $5 million bond, saying the nature of the offense is shocking.
He was told to stop by police officers. They risked their own safety to try and step in front of the car to stop him. Everything was done to get him to stop, and he just simply continued down the roadway, causing death and destruction in his path.
This morning, Brooks is facing 5 first-degree intentional homicide charges. Prosecutors say they will add another homicide charge for the child who just died.
Video shows the moments in which Brooks was put under arrest. Daniel Ryder is sharing Ring doorbell video from his house, just half a mile from the parade route.
Hands up! Put your hands where I can see you! Hands up!
Whoa, whoa, whoa!
Hands up! Hands up! Hands up! Hands up!
26th, 500 block, Elizabeth, 126.
Ryder says he was watching football when Brooks rang his doorbell, claimed he was homeless, and asked to use his phone to call an Uber. Ryder says he didn't know at the time what had happened at the parade.
Keep in mind, the whole time he had my phone, so my shelter in place and a suspect on the loose messages, I wasn't seeing them. And if they were sent before, I was watching the game, so I didn't see them. I had no idea anything had happened.
We have posted Ryder's entire Ring doorbell video on our website for you to watch. You can head over to channel3000.com to do so.
We could get a verdict this week in the Ahmaud Arbery murder case. The fate of 3 men charged with killing Arbery early last year is now in the hands of the jury. If a decision is not made today, deliberations could start back up Friday. Saturday is also an option. The defense maintains the men were trying to make a citizen's arrest. Outside the courthouse yesterday, Arbery's mother expressed confidence in the predominantly white jury.
6:02 now. Chris Reese here with your first warm weather. You're certified most accurate. Hey, Chris.
Yeah, good morning. We're talking about travel across the country today, tomorrow, and even into parts of your Black Friday. It's a busy travel period around here, and for the most part, no delays are expected. Now, we are tracking some minor delays throughout parts of the High Plains and into the Rockies. That's going to be from mountain snow that's starting to move this direction. But we push forward into tonight, and the only minor delays, that's going to be across parts of the Midwest and the Southern Plains. That's from rain. And then perhaps some of those minor delays and even moderate delays into parts of your Thanksgiving morning. That's again as that rain continues to work its way southward. That being said, here's future track. You see the snow throughout parts of the mountains. Here's that rain and even our little flurry chance that we're going to have throughout parts of Wisconsin tomorrow in the morning. Outside of that, things are generally quiet. By Friday, we are talking about the possibility of a couple of snowflakes throughout parts of the Northeast, and then once again in the mountains of the North and West. But it really doesn't get much better than this for this time of the year. So let's talk temperatures this morning, because we are warm. 30s all across the board. Janesville is at 39, same for Lone Rock, 40 in Viroqua, 42 in Boscobel. Right here in Madison, it's 37. You see that cloud icon? We're gonna see that cloud icon all day long. Get used to the cloud cover, but yes, we are warmer. In some cases, by 25 degrees when you compare it to 24 hours ago. Madison, 15 degrees warmer than 24 hours ago. Doppler track staying quiet. This is our cold front. That cold front moves quickly throughout the rest of this afternoon, and that arrives here later on tonight. It'll bring with it a chance for a sprinkle. But I will tell you, this version of Future Track just a wee bit overdone there. A lot of us are going to be drier as we go throughout today. Later on tonight into tomorrow, we'll see our chance for some flurries. Once again, Future Track a wee bit overdone. I'm expecting flurries not all out snow showers. So we'll see some flurries as we start to move into tomorrow. That'll wrap up into the afternoon. Temperatures, though, dropping. We're at 30 by 4 o'clock. Then we'll continue to fall into the 20s, all the way down to 16 Thanksgiving night and into Friday. So we go from 51 to 16, really within about 24 to 36 hours. And yes, we'll see those chances for snowflakes on Thanksgiving Day. Perhaps a chance for some rain and snow on Saturday night into Sunday. That's what we're going to take a look at coming up in just a bit.
All right, sounds good. Thank you, Chris. 6:05 now. This is what the family of Parker Cruz has been looking at for months. For 143 days, they've been out on the Wisconsin River using high-tech gear to search for Parker, who went missing in early July. News 2 Now's Anna Hansen this morning on Parker's mother, who has been out on the river several times, and her ongoing search as the appreciation for those who are helping along the way grows.
Cold just isn't a problem for Jackie Johnson Cruz. Donning many layers, Johnson Cruz spends hours each week in a boat loaned to her by a local man, scouring the bottom of the Wisconsin River with a high-tech scanner given to her for free, searching for any remnant of her 22-year-old son.
At this point, this far out, we don't know what to expect to find when we find Parker, but supposedly we'll know it when we see him.
Parker Cruz went missing in the river on July 3rd, falling into the water while trying to help a boater in distress. His mother says this act of courage was perfectly in line with his character.
He was always helping people, and he's the kind of person he was just always willing to help somebody.
The local fire department spent about a week searching, but eventually needed to move on. Johnson Cruz and her sisters stepped up to the plate, learning to navigate the waters Parker disappeared in.
We were searching every day up until I had to go back to work on November 1st, basically. We just come out when we can.
It's her hope that her efforts on the water will eventually help others.
This isn't going to be the last tragedy that happens in the Wisconsin River. And with this, with what we've learned from this, we hope to, you know, be able to help another family in need.
Regardless of the weather, Johnson Cruz says she'll be on the river every chance she gets until she brings Parker home.
We're just going to be out as long as we can. We're not going to give up on Parker.
In Spring Green, Anna Hansen, News 3 Now.
The Cruz family is asking anyone who can donate sonar equipment or do anything to help to join their Facebook group. It's called Promise Parker.
A Fond du Lac cold case getting a little bit warmer this morning. 13 years to the day after hunters discovered Jane Doe's body in the frozen creek in the town of Ashford, officials released her name, identifying her as Amy Marie Urie. She would have been 18 years old when she died in 2008.
She was positively identified using three different means: comparison of DNA from her mother, comparison of DNA from her sister, and a comparison of dental x-rays.
The sheriff says Urie was a victim of sex trafficking, spending time in Milwaukee, Chicago, and Beloit. They're still trying to piece together how she was killed and why her body was taken up north.
Coming up, Badger men's basketball coming down to the wire in the Maui Invitational. See if Wisconsin could pull it off.
And we're in the 608 to preview Madison's original turkey trot returning Thanksgiving.
The holidays brought a great gift this year. It's my Rogan's receipt. Next time, with the receipt, my purchase will be half price. Maybe some new boots.
Selection, service, name brands, and the second pair is half price. Visit online at roganshoes.com.
The holidays are doubly important this year, so make your celebrations doubly special with our award-winning cave-aged Murray's cheese. Pick and save. Hey, you're right, we can't stop now. Let's take the special up a level with fresh, never frozen prime beef. Still not special enough? Add some surf to that turf with our sustainably caught seafood. Turn your taste buds up to 11 and have a doubly special holiday with Pick and Save, fresh for everyone.
It's time to find your next Chevy truck and forge ahead. Take on new challenges and take it to the next level. It's the perfect time to do more in your next Chevy. Find new possibilities, find new roads. Very well qualified buyers can get 2.49% financing and $1,000 cash allowance on this Silverado. Plus, unlock your code to claim $500 Chevy CyberCash on most Silverado 1500 crew cab pickups.
Can be, oh, so stressful. So give the the gift of wellness. Buy $100 in Massage Envy gift cards and receive a free $20 promo card. Keep your body working.
Hey, guys.
Hey, Dad.
You ready?
This holiday, U.S. Cellular is doing a little something extra to keep everyone connected. Right now, choose any phone from any brand at any of our stores for free. Plus, save big with unlimited data for our best price of the season, just $30 a month. Now that's a deal to cheer about. Feel the locally grown joy from U.S. Cellular, America's locally grown wireless.
Is your credit score getting in the way of the things you want to do? Personal loans through NetCredit offer fast and flexible lending. Borrow up to $10,000 and choose repayment terms that work for you. You may even be able to build your credit history as you repay. NetCredit, a more personal loan.
The season for dress and casual boots is here, and Rogan's has your next pair. Savings with 20% off the best name brands. Get the latest trends today and save at Rogan's.
Selection, service, name brands, and the second pair is half price. Visit online at roganshoes.com.
You're watching News 3 Now This Morning, winner of the National Edward R. Murrow Award for Overall Excellence in Television.
Welcome back. We are getting ready to celebrate Thanksgiving in the 608. But first, we've got a way to help out the community, have a little fun, too.
Josh Brider live this morning to preview Madison's original turkey trot set to return tomorrow. Hey, Josh.
Hey guys, good morning. Yeah, a lot of excitement surrounding the return of Madison's original turkey trot. Of course, we're here at the Alliant Energy Center, which is going to be hustling and bustling tomorrow morning with all those turkeys, including Kim Anderson, who's all dressed up for the occasion this morning. You know, you're with UCP of Dane County, and this is a huge, huge event for you guys.
Yes, it is. We are looking forward to seeing lots of trotting turkeys out here tomorrow.
You know, you already have last weekend, you said the number was up to around 1,200. You're hoping for 2,000 people, and this all helps out what you guys do at UCP.
Yes, we do provide services for children and families who are disabled or are working with disabilities in their families. And, you know, one of our main missions is to promote community. And we do that in a lot of ways, but one important way is our youth resources that provides inclusive child care services, which allows disabled children to learn and play right alongside their peers right within their programs.
Yeah, this is a great way to promote that. We've got some video we want to show of past events, and this is a great way to get all the community back, right? This has been something that we've been missing over the last couple of years.
That's right. We did not have the in-person live turkey trot last year. It was virtual, which is still great. We were able to still, do that, but we're going to be so happy to see everybody actually out here in their costumes, running the race, and it's really fun to watch everybody have that fun.
And this is truly something for people of all ages.
It really is, yeah. And we have a kids dash in the morning for 8 and under. We have a fun run for those 11 and unders, and then everybody else can run the regular 5K. Well, you can run, walk, or you can roll. Bring a stroller, or even if you're in a wheelchair.
Whatever works for you. You know, so if people are interested, there's still time to sign up.
There is. You can register online. And if you do register, please use the code UCP10. Indicates that gives us a little bit more of a boost on our fundraising.
Very good. Well, thank you so much for everything that you're doing, Kim. And I'm looking forward to seeing all the pictures out of here tomorrow, because this costume, guys, this is incredible. You know I love a good costume here in the 608. Kim, we thank you so much. Of course, we're going to get all of this up on channel3000.com. I should have stolen the turkey costume from the Goodman Center last week so I could have that out here. And I might be a little warmer as well. A little chilly out here on Wednesday, but weather hopefully going to be holding up for all those turkeys trotting around tomorrow, guys.
Yeah, where do you even get an apron like that?
Pretty impressive.
Doesn't that look good? Isn't that great? They're asking where you get an apron like that.
Can I say where I got it? Party City, actually. They
Party
were almost
City.
Out of all their stuff, but
there you go.
I got, like, the last apron that was hanging on the...
Well, now I know what I'm getting
well,
Josh
there you
for
go.
Christmas.
Yeah, now you guys know what you're getting me for Christmas. How about that?
All right, great cause. Glad you're highlighting that this morning, Josh. Thanks.
Josh never misses a chance to dress up. I'm shocked.
I love it. I'm here right for now. Every single outfit.
Aren't we all? Josh, thank you very much. Remember to let him know what inspires you in the 608. Reach out to him on social media or shoot him an email.
Well, Wisconsin taking over the Maui Invitational in Las Vegas this year. First tough come from behind win against Texas A&M this week, but 12th-ranked Houston, they would be a new test. Wisconsin carrying Monday's momentum into yesterday, especially Johnny Davis. Just one day after scoring a career-high 21, he beat that, dropping 30 yesterday. Halftime, Wisconsin up by 20. Houston, though, cuts into that lead during the second half and gives himself an opportunity to win it late. That did not work out for the Cougars, though. Badgers win this one, 65-63, your final. The Badgers are going to take on St. Mary's in the final today at 4.
Looking ahead this morning, the next celebrity heading into space, now announced. Jeff Bezos' rocket company, Blue Origin, will be sending Good Morning America host Michael Strahan to the edge of space. He's set to lift off on December 9th with the daughter of the first American astronaut and 4 other paying customers. It's going to be a short trip. The rocket is expected to be in space for only 10 minutes. Another brilliant PR move by Blue Origin.
I hear you. I know. It gets us talking about it.
Got to cover it if you put a, you know, a personality on the board.
You think Good Morning America would have something on that? They might. Okay. We joke. 6:16. Let's check it with Chris Reese now. Here on CBS, home of CBS Mornings.
But wait a minute. Hold
where
on.
You should be.
Look at this shot.
Hey, wow.
Yeah, a second day in a row with a beautiful sunrise around here. We've got the cloud cover coming in, but there's just enough sun low on the horizon that you have just this kiss of fire right there on the base of the cloud cover. Is that not just a beautiful shot? We are spoiled in Wisconsin time and time again. The cloud cover, though, that wins. We're going to see more and more of that as we go throughout today. So look for more and more of the color gray today when you are out and about, because you're going to be seeing it. Temperatures stay into the 40s for the most part, but I do believe we top out right around that 50-degree mark, probably between noon and 4, right around 3 is when that's going to happen. We continue to look at that pattern ahead, though, in particular the weekend. You all already know that today and tomorrow are generally going to be smooth. What I'm paying attention to is a system that's trying to develop Saturday night into Sunday. You just saw it there. It moves through quickly, but the models differ on how exactly they want to handle that. This right here is model 2. You see the same system. It's not as widespread. It's much more thin. But once again, Saturday night into Sunday, we see that zipping through. I know a lot of folks travel up north, maybe want to drive back. This is something to pay attention to. I'll tell you, it does not look like a major deal by any means. That's the comfort, but it's something that I am watching. If you're traveling across the country today, though, the northern plains, it's cold. A couple of snowflakes can't be ruled out throughout parts of the Dakotas. Generally, barely quiet throughout parts of the Northeast. Still a little chilly in the 40s and 50s. We're warm down south, but even then, it's cold for Texas this time of the year. Temperatures will be into the 70s, 60s out in California.
All right, 60s. California. Doesn't that sound nice?
No. Who wants to be in California when you can be in Wisconsin?
I know. Wisconsin's the best state ever. So.
Did you see that kiss of fire?
That kiss of fire was pretty awesome.
Come on, Chris.
Very nice. I hear you.
I
made a decision to come back to Wisconsin. I love it so much.
From
but doesn't
south,
mean I don't want to get away sometimes and find a nice beach somewhere.
Fair. Fair.
All right. 6:18 and more local news this morning. We hear it before each holiday season. Buy local if you can. Business in our area, they kicked off their annual effort yesterday, the Dane by Local initiative. They invited people to Sun Prairie, where they talked about the 12th year of their Shop Local initiative. A reminder, this Saturday is Small Business Saturday.
Epic is looking to squash hunger this week with a food drive for squash. Staff brought in donations for local food pantries and in return could pick up a butternut squash and raffle tickets. 7,000 locally grown squashes were brought in for the event.
Well, a year after the pandemic forced a lot of us to stay home for Thanksgiving, travelers are making up for lost time, according to AAA, if you're traveling today or anytime this week. You're joining more than 53 million Americans traveling this year. Around 1 million of those are from Wisconsin. Most people will be driving. 95,000 Wisconsinites, though, are expected to fly overall. Thanksgiving travel up 13% from last year in both Wisconsin and nationally.
Joe Biden releasing 50 million barrels of oil from the Strategic Petroleum Reserve this morning. That announcement comes as gas prices in the country reaching highs never seen before. Supply is largely determined by the OPEC cartel in the Middle East. A release from the White House says this is an attempt to undermine their control on the market.
So if you are driving somewhere for Thanksgiving today, how will it impact you at the pump? The national average right now for a gallon of gas, about $3.39. It's a little better in the Midwest, including here in Wisconsin, where the average gallon of gas is about $3.12. So both in Dana Rock counties, a gallon of gas averaging just over $3 a gallon.
Okay, 6:20 now. Today is your final day for a chance to win a pair of News 3 Now coffee mugs with our question of the day.
All you have to do is go to our website, channel3000.com, and answer that question of the day. We're asking you, do you buy a real Christmas tree? Yes or no?
Both Chris and I do every single year. It's always been a family tradition. Every Black Friday, we head to the Christmas tree farm out in Fenimore, Wisconsin.
Very
Cook's
nice.
Woods. Cut down our tree, get some garland. It's a lovely experience.
There you go. Got to get the fresh garland to go with it.
Yeah.
Oh, nothing like it. The smells. I mean, that just, it completes the whole environment for
yes.
me. When your house is not only looking like Christmas, but you smell like Christmas too.
Couldn't agree more. Oh, but yeah. Hey, if you don't get a real Christmas tree, that's okay. Yes or no answers are eligible for that pair of coffee mugs. Just head to channel3000.com/contests to answer. It's also right up on the homepage. 6:21 now, a surprise visitor for one school in Tennessee.
And coming up in our next half hour, an extended mask mandate for Dane County. This one is a little different, though. We'll break down an exception after the break.
With a nursing degree, helping others went from a job to a career.
Cobison Buses, now hiring.
After we backed that bus out of its stall and started driving, I just loved it. We really get a chance to get to know each other. Almost everyone has a different story about how they came to bus driving. So you really end up feeling like you're part of a family.
Visit Cobison.com to apply.
This time of year, you can find deals on lots of vehicles. But compared to many, a new Volkswagen SUV costs less to maintain, which can save you money over the next 5 years. Isn't that illuminating? Put your money to better use this holiday at the Volkswagen Sign Then Drive event. Hurry in during the Volkswagen Sign Then Drive event and lease an all-new 2022 Taos for zero down, zero deposit, 0 first month's payment, and 0 due at signing.
There's been much debate about the Mona Lisa smile. Would it have been bigger and brighter if she'd had good dental care? Maybe if Physicians Mutual Insurance Company had been around back then, it'd be a different story. She could have gone to the dentist more, knowing she'd have help paying the bills. And those regular checkups might have found early signs of tooth decay or gum disease, costly problems that could keep anyone from smiling. Physicians Mutual offers affordable coverage that can help pay for cleanings and unexpected or expensive procedures you might need, like crowns or dentures. This is real dental insurance, not just a discount plan or for checkups only. There are no deductibles and there's no annual maximum. Plus, you can see any dentist you want. Call or go online today for a free information kit from Physicians Mutual. Get the dental care you need to help you stay healthy. For your free information kit with all the details, call us now or go to sendinfokit.com.
I'm Rebecca, and you might know me from reality TV.
And this was my stubborn body fat that I just couldn't get rid of. But then I went to Sono Bello, and they permanently removed my body fat in just one visit.
It is so intensely gratifying for one visit to make this big of a change. It's amazing.
Sono Bello's board-certified surgeons use microlaser technology to safely target and remove your diet-resistant fat cells permanently on your stomach, hips and thighs, back, and so much more.
It feels incredible to look down and it's flat.
Thank you again, Sono Bello. I'm so happy.
Schedule your free, no-obligation consultation and find out how you can get $250 off instantly. Call 1-800-595-1532 or go to sonobello.com.
Cobison Buses, now hiring.
Working with Cobison, it's definitely been great because of the flexibility. If you do need time off, they work around you. They definitely try to make it a company that's based for you.
Visit Cobison.com to apply.
Welcome back. We always ask you to share your morning with us. We got this stunner straight out of The Lion King from Mr. Theo. It's the first time I've heard you sing. It's not so bad.
It's not the first time you've heard me sing.
Yeah, it is. I truly think
I'm with Leah on this one.
It just means the other times haven't been as memorable.
Well, I mean, you don't have the vibrato that I can kill.
No,
but.
no church lady choir voice. Great picture.
Mama Beach.
All right, that's good.
Okay, I'm done.
Thanks, Theo, for sharing your morning with us. Use the hashtag MyNews3Mornings so we can find it on social media. Maybe we'll sing you a tune.
Okay, we're done now. 6:25, a deer making an unannounced visit to a school in Tennessee.
Yeah, the buck crashed through an emergency exit to get inside, spent the night locked inside of this classroom. The deer knocked over a few tables, chairs.
Look at the mess here. You're going to see it in a second.
Yeah. They called in a wildlife officer to get the deer and then release it back in the wild. Yeah, a little mess. Just there's the officer.
Just another day in the life of that teacher, I'm sure.
Yeah. Okay. Teacher's probably like, yeah, this isn't as bad as what I normally have to clean up every day.
Deer's quieter than the kids.
Yeah.
Same mess, quieter day.
Crazy. I always wonder what that's going to be like for the deer. Deer's like, what the heck is going on?
Poor guy. I feel bad for him. Kind of looks like he lost an antler. Hope it wasn't in the classroom.
All right, Chris Reese, hit us with the commute forecast.
Buddy. Yeah, real quick, if you're getting ready to travel today, no issues are expected. Green means go. We say that on News 3 Now this morning all the time, and the green light is what you have. But we're going to talk about what to expect when we come back and when we could see a chance for some flakes as well.
News 3 Now First Warn Weather is brought to you by Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor.
Discover a shopping and design experience as comfortable as the furniture. Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor. Schedule your free design consultation today.
Vitense Golfland Golf Suites. Practice in a golf range in comfort year-round. Enjoy the practice and entertainment experience with friendly VIP grill and bar service, heated tee areas, comfortable overhead heated seating, music, and HD TVs. Only at Vitense Golfland.
The season for dress and casual boots is here, and Rogan's has your next pair. Savings with 20% off the best name brands. Get the latest trends today and save at Rogan's.
Selection, service, name brands, and the second pair is half price. Visit online at RoganShoes.com.
Precision engineering. Rigorous attention to detail. A Bryant Evolution heating system is so well designed, it's as much of a joy to install as it is to use.
Good to go.
Bryant, whatever it takes.
Breathe easy. Contact AirServe for quality AC repair. Finally, a heating and cooling company you can count on.
Shop the Black Friday sale at Grand Appliance for deals like this Amana top load washer for just $4.98, this GE convection gas range with air fry for just $8.48, or this Samsung 28 cubic foot French door for just $14.98. That's not all. Save up to $1,000 more exclusively at Grand Appliance with select purchases of our most popular brands. Don't miss this sale at Grand Appliance, appliance expert since 1930.
We love our house. Been here for years.
Yeah, but there's an animal in the attic. At least Geico makes bundling our home and car insurance easy.
We save a lot.
For bundling made easy, go to geico.com.
Hey, guys.
Hey, Dad.
You ready?
This holiday, U.S. Cellular is doing a little something extra to keep everyone connected. Right now, choose any phone from any brand at any of our stores for free. Plus, save big with unlimited data for our best price of the season, just $30 a month. Now that's a deal to cheer about. Feel the locally grown joy from U.S. Cellular, America's locally grown wireless.
Keep your family warm this season with new winter boots. Rogan's has 20% off the best name brands for mom, dad, and the kids. Save on winter boots for the whole family from Rogan's.
Selection, service, name brands, and the second pair is half price. Visit online at RoganShoes.com.
Vitense Golfland now offers two indoor golf and multi-sport simulator suites. Play over 100 championship golf courses with unmatched golf swing data and visualization. Or play other sports and games using real sports equipment. The Vitense Golfland simulator suites provides a fun indoor entertainment experience.
Right now, the number of those killed in the Waukesha parade up to six this morning. The latest victim, a child.
And you'll need to keep your mask on in Dane County a while longer. The new exception for those vaccinated in the extended order.
And I may not be traveling for Thanksgiving this year, but there's a chance you are. We're going to follow that forecast as you get ready to hit the road.
A lot of folks headed out this morning. It's the busiest road travel day of the year today. Yeah, so we welcome you in on that busy travel day here on News 3 Now this morning. I'm Chris Stanford.
And I'm Leah Lynch. I had lots to get to today. Mm-hmm. We start with our top story. 8-year-old Jackson Sparks, now the sixth victim killed in the Waukesha parade after being hit by a speeding SUV.
Jackson and his 12-year-old brother were both hit and seriously hurt Sunday. The Sparks family asking for privacy this morning. They did release this statement through LifePoint Church saying they appreciate the continued prayers and outpouring of support. Children's Hospital Wisconsin say that they are still caring for 13 other children. Six are in critical condition.
The man accused of killing those six people and injuring 50 others is now in jail with a bond set at millions.
So I know that that's extraordinarily high bail. It's warranted here, and I am setting cash bail in the amount of $5 million.
39-year-old Daryl Brooks appearing in court yesterday for the first time. Court documents filed as part of his appearance say police at the scene felt he intentionally tried to hit as many people as possible. He's charged with five counts of first-degree intentional homicide right now. Lawyers in court said they would be filing a sixth charge after learning of Jackson's death.
We're seeing tremendous amounts of support for all the victims and their families. The deaths now range in age from 8 to 81. The Jewish community of Waukesha hosting their One Community, One Heart event yesterday to honor all affected by the incident. Several leaders from different religious and families from the community coming together to support the victims by setting a 12-foot menorah, which is dedicated to those impacted by Sunday's tragedy.
This is way beyond any particular view. This is not political. This is human, and we are coming together.
One community, one heart, one purpose, to never forget and to honor their fellow neighbors whose lives were forever changed Sunday night.
If you would like to donate to the victims and their families, we have links to multiple verified GoFundMe pages and to the United for Waukesha Community Fund. Those are up on channel3000.com as well as our Channel 3000 mobile app.
All right, the mask order now. Public Health Madison Dane County says people in the county will need to keep their masks on through New Year's. The decision coming 3 weeks after officials said the current mandate would be the last for now, which was set to expire on Saturday. So this new mandate extension says if you're inside with people who are fully vaccinated, you can ditch the mask. Public Health Director says rising cases, especially among children, were just too high to ignore.
Right now, we're unable to determine what our current pace of vaccination is. I think where we want to see is having that full immunity by vaccine conferred to our youngest kiddos and to see the impact of that on our total population.
Heinrich also says that we don't need to eliminate COVID in Dane County to get rid of the mask order, but she says we need to be in a spot somewhere where schools, hospitals, and public health can manage. Now that fully vaccinated exceptions are in place, it's kind of vague, so let's break down the language here. The order states that you can remove a mask when in an enclosed space with individuals who are fully vaccinated. It doesn't go on to say really anything else about it. No parameters set for the venues. They classify fully vaccinated, though, as 2 weeks after a completed two-dose vaccine series like a Pfizer or a Moderna shot, or 2 weeks after a single-dose J&J shot.
Students in the Oregon School District will be required to wear their masks a few days longer than the rest of Dane County, at least for now. Masks will be required for students in 7th through 12th grades until January 10th. Again, the Dane County mask mandate ends the 3rd. After that, they'll be strongly encouraged but not required. Students in kindergarten through 6th grade will be required to wear masks until January 24th.
Minnesota has one of the highest 7-day averages of COVID cases in the country right now. Cases are so high that the military is now stepping in to help treat COVID patients in some cities.
Just about every hospital in the state is in a tough shape in terms of how stretched thin they are, how hard their workers have been working for 20 plus months now.
One emergency team is set up at the Hennepin County Medical Center in Minneapolis, which has been at or over capacity consistently. The other team is in western Minnesota in St. Cloud.
Organizers of the 2017 Deadly Unite the Right rally in Charlottesville will pay more than $25 million in damages to the victims. This comes after a jury found the group of white nationalists were responsible for the violence in a month-long civil trial. This week, the jury was deadlocked on two claims, but found the 24 defendants were liable for the death of one woman and injuries to another 19.
Verdict today is a message that this country does not tolerate violence based on racial and religious hatred in any form.
The 2017 rally was organized to protest the removal of a Robert E. Lee statue in the city. The defendant's attorneys say they will file a motion to reduce those damages.
Time is 6:35. Checking out with Chris Reese now in Madison's certified most accurate forecast. Hey, Chris.
You're getting ready to hit the road. Let's talk about it. Today, no issues. We're going to be cloudy, but things are going to be warm. By Friday, we're cold, but things are dry. The only day that we're tracking any kind of precipitation is Thanksgiving. We're talking about flurries in the morning. Even still, that's not going to be an impact because I'm talking flurries, not snow showers like what we saw last Thursday. Just a couple of stray flurries out there for tomorrow. That's going to be a part of a cold front. It's back to our north and west, and it's going to be moving our direction as we go throughout today. It takes a while to get here, so it really doesn't arrive until later on tonight. But temperatures are going to fall once that cold front moves through. It is a very strong cold front coming through here. Out ahead of it, we're going to be warm. Temperatures are already about 15 to 20 degrees warmer than they were 24 hours ago. Jane Zell, you are at 39 this morning. That's closer to our average high this time of the year, but that's where we're starting things out. 37 in the Dells. Bosque Belle is at 42, 43 for La Crosse. Right here in Madison, it's 37. So we planned the day. You see the cloud cover moving in. I'm going to stop the clock at 3. We're at 50, but notice that blanket of gray that we have across southern Wisconsin. Winds are out of the north and west and parts of Minnesota at that point. That's the cold front moving in. So now I'm stopping the clock at 10. You see, our winds are now out of the north and west. We're at 43. 30 show up just towards the north. 46 towards Janesville. We get colder through the overnight hours. We also start to see our chances for snow showers during the overnight hours. And again, most of it's just light flurry activity. 9:30 tomorrow, we're at 32. You see the 20s back towards the north and west. You also see that chance for flurries throughout parts of southern Wisconsin. Hey, if this shows up, this bodes well for the bold prediction that I gave you last month on October 25th, that we would at least see snow showers or snow on the ground for Thanksgiving, Christmas, and New Year. Things are looking up for that. Once we clear things out as we move into the afternoon, temperatures stay in the 30s. We're at 31 at 2:30. So that's what I put for your high temperature on Thursday. Your high temperature on Thursday is really going to be in the upper 30s. That's at midnight. Temperatures fall throughout the day. We go all the way down to 16. Thursday night, Black Friday, we don't get above freezing.
My goodness. All right, Chris Reese, thank you.
My pleasure.
Okay, speaking of Thanksgiving, millions of people across country will be traveling today ahead of the holiday.
If you're driving anytime over the next few days, travel experts do have some advice for you. They say the best time to leave is after 9 o'clock tonight and before 11 o'clock tomorrow or Friday morning.
So as everyone goes home over the weekend, you can expect more delays. Experts say the best time to leave on Saturday and Sunday is before noon.
A lot of folks are going to be flying for Thanksgiving weekend. Airports are going to be packed, so please plan for that. A few things to keep in mind if you're flying. Give yourself plenty of time to get through security. If you're planning to use Uber or Lyft, you may actually want to schedule a ride ahead of time because there is a driver shortage. And don't forget your mask. No matter where you're going, masks are mandatory in airports and on airplanes. So, where's everyone going this year?
According to AAA, a lot of people taking vacation for the holiday. Here are a few of the top destinations this year. Disney World in Orlando, Florida, number one.
Yeah, Disneyland in Anaheim, California, coming in at number two. New York City in the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade is number three.
And number one internationally, Cancun, Mexico.
Nice. Number two, Montego Bay, Jamaica. How's that sound? And rounding out the top three, Aruba.
You know, I'm a big fan of Wisconsin during the holidays, but I could take Aruba.
I know. In February, Aruba will sound really nice. Like, you I love right. myself some beach and some sun. But hey, nothing beats Wisconsin around family for the holidays, does it?
You are absolutely right. 6:39 now, so we're in Wisconsin, not Aruba. The chance for flakes back in the forecast.
What a sunrise.
Ooh, but look first, take in that sight. Grab your cup of coffee. Tune in for Chris Reese's forecast coming up after the break.
And don't do this tomorrow, folks. Your annual reminder not to deep fry a frozen turkey.
Plus, we're in the 608 to preview Madison's original turkey trot when we come back.
Keep your home and family warm and cozy this winter with a new degree of comfort from your local Rheem contractor.
Feel the Wohlers difference. Call Wohlers Heating and Air Conditioning today. Serving Dane County for over 45 years.
Make this holiday season special when you use the Pick and Save app to get personalized coupons, rewards like fuel points, and weekly deals. So you can get exactly what you want at prices that are lower than low. Pick and save, fresh for everyone.
What does it mean to fight for what's right? And who decides what's right? Is it right for an insurance adjuster to try to get you to settle for less than you deserve? Is it right to let victims struggle to pay their medical bills? To us, it means helping accident victims get their lives back to normal again. It means doing what's right for you. Habish, Habish, and Rotier. We fight for what's right.
The Dove Beauty Bar makes my skin feel fresh. I've encouraged Serena, my best friend, to switch.
Feels moisturized and clean. My friend Stephanie, her skin was dry. I'm like, girl, you better get you some Dove.
She hooked me up.
With a quarter moisturizing cream, Dove cleans effectively and cares beautifully.
Black Friday's happening now at Steinhoffels. Get great Black Friday deals and reward yourself with a $100, $200, or $300 MasterCard rewards card. Plus, get amazing deals like this queen bed, just $99. This entertainment center, now $249. This sofa, just $299. A queen beauty rest mattress, only $299. A five-piece dining set, now $729. Save big and reward yourself during Steinhoffels Black Friday sale. Only at Steinhoffels and Steinhoffels.com.
Is your credit score getting in the way of things you want to do? Personal loans through NetCredit help you borrow up to $10,000. So check your eligibility on NetCredit.com today without affecting your credit score. You may even be able to build your credit history as you repay. NetCredit, a more personal, personal loan.
With Pick and Save delivery, it's easy to get your special holiday foods brought right to your door. And that's music to your ears. Pick and Save, fresh for everyone.
Is your home giving you the cold shoulder? Fight back with a new energy-saving furnace from your local Rheem contractor.
Feel the Wohlers difference. Call Wohlers Heating and Air Conditioning today. Serving Dane County for over 45 years.
She's on a mission.
Dishwasher, she is a fire pistol.
Leading her fighters in the battle of their lives.
Come on, Joel, let's go!
Charlotte Deleste introduces you to a fitness trainer giving hope to people fighting a terrible disease. Tonight on News 3 Now at 6. When it comes to weather, only one thing really matters. Accuracy.
Only one station can be the best.
News 3 Now. First Warn Weather has the most accurate forecast, according to WeatherRate.
Count on First Warn Weather for your most accurate forecast.
You're watching News 3 Now This Morning, winner of the National Edward R. Murrow Award for Overall Excellence in Television.
Hi, Chris. Patsy Weber from Highland. Please plan my day. Good morning, Leah.
Aww.
Yes.
That made my day.
I knew it. I knew. Finally, a Highland. I was so excited.
You've been asking. When,
yes. We have some folks from Highland who have sent in their videos, and yep. Even threw in the good morning Leah there at the end. That was really nice. So we're going to plan the day. Look at this sun, a fiery sky. I love it in the morning. Typically, they say red skies at morning. Sailors warning, though. The warning is a cold front that's going to come through. It does not have a ton of moisture, but we are going to be tracking a cold front that increases the cloud cover throughout the day. Temperatures warm up to about 50 before that cold front actually moves in. But tomorrow, We will struggle to get above freezing. That is if we do. Tomorrow afternoon, likely going to be cold and dry. Tomorrow morning, we're going to see some of those snow showers and flurries moving through. Doppler track is quiet for today. If you're traveling out and about, no issues are really expected. Only minor delays from a cold front that is going to bring some chances for some rain. And you see our little snow chance moving through as well. Otherwise, the roller coaster, we're getting ready for the drop. We are right at the tippy top of it today. And then we are going down and yelling timber in the process. So, 31, 32, 39, and 37, that's the weekend.
Dude, 51, heck. I'll take that.
Heck and heck.
Mm-hmm. All right, Chris Reese, thank you very much. So we are ready to celebrate Thanksgiving in the 608, but first, we've got a way to help out the community and to have a little fun.
We sure do. Josh Breiter is live this morning to preview Madison's original turkey trot and its return tomorrow. Hey, Josh.
Hey guys, good morning. Yeah, a lot of excitement surrounding the return of the original turkey trot here in Madison. We're at the Alliant Energy Center this morning, which of course is where this is going to be taking place this tomorrow. And we're going to have a lot of turkeys out here tomorrow, including Kim Anderson, who's all dressed up for us this morning. And you are super excited. You're with UCP of Dane County, and this all really benefits you guys. It's one of your biggest events of the year.
Yes, we are the charity of record for the original Madison turkey trot here at the Alliant Energy Center tomorrow. And we're excited to get all the runners and families and anybody who wants to come out and have a good time in the outdoors tomorrow.
So we've got some video from past events. This is really a good time to get the entire family together, but the meaning behind it's even more special.
Yeah, you know, raising money for people in our community in the 608 here who are struggling with disabilities is kind of the goal. And the services that UCP, United Cerebral Palsy of Greater Dane County, provides creates opportunities for families to take a break through our respite staff, spending time with their disabled children, for example, so that they can recharge and be ready to give their all to their kids again. And so that's just one of the many programs, and I encourage everybody to visit our website, UCPDane.org, to learn more and become more aware of the needs in our community.
Yeah, Madison's original turkey trot. This is a great way to get all people together, right? This, yeah. There's really something for all ages.
Yes, we have the Kids Dash for 8 and under, which is going to be super fun. That's free. The Fun Run 5K for the kids who are 11 and under, an untimed event, so there's no pressure on them. They can just run and have fun. And then, of course, the traditional 5K walk, run, or roll.
So you guys are hoping for 2,000 people tomorrow. If people are still interested, there's still time to sign up, right?
There is. If you go to wisconsinruns.com and make sure you click on the Madison turkey trot, because there's a Milwaukee turkey trot too, but we want you to click on the Madison one. And then register and enter UCP10 so that UCP gets a little bit of an extra 10%.
Very good. Well, yeah, we'll get this up on channel3000.com. Link it all there. Mark, if we can zoom into Kim's little headband there. She's got the little gobble gobble on here. Kim, I always love a good dress up like this. You know, I've been a turkey. I've been Santa lately. You're definitely outdoing me this morning. But I'm looking forward to seeing all the costumes tomorrow.
Oh, yeah. People will be in tutus and headbands and special, full turkey costumes. And it's always a fun event to see that kind of stuff going on.
Well, very good, Kim. Thank you so much for being here. We appreciate you and all of the work you're doing, and happy Thanksgiving.
Thank you. You as well. Happy Thanksgiving to everybody out there.
Yes, thank you so much, guys. We'll send it back to you in the studio. Happy Thanksgiving, Chris, Leah, and Chris Reese, everyone back there. Hope you guys have a wonderful holiday. We'll be back in the 608 on Friday morning.
Josh, happy Thanksgiving to you too, but I have to say I'm a little disappointed. I know you love a good turkey costume. I was expecting a little better today.
I know, you know, I kind of dropped the ball on that one. I should have kept the Goodman turkey. Right. Maybe next year I'll just have to, like, hold on to that through the Thanksgiving holiday, right? It's also really warm, too, so on a cold morning like this, that would have been really nice.
Next time.
Can't get enough of Josh dressing up in a costume.
Who can?
Josh, happy Thanksgiving, buddy. See you Friday.
Remember to let Josh know what inspires you in the 608. You can reach out to him on social media or shoot him an email for a chance to be featured.
All right, everybody's going to be cooking tomorrow, so let's talk about safety. The National Fire Protection Association says that there are more cooking fires on Thanksgiving Day than any other day of the year. And demonstrations like this one just shows how dumb it is to deep fry a frozen turkey. It can be safe, just don't do it when they're frozen. If you're trying to fry a turkey, it's got to be fully thawed And that can even still be dangerous. Firefighters urge caution, though, in all aspects of the kitchen.
Because kids can reach up and get a handle, pull something hot down on themselves. So again, make sure you're supervising your kids around any kind of cooking that's going on during the holiday season.
You should see me in the kitchen cooking with all my kids running around.
Fiery mess?
I'm like an NHL goalie, like a hockey goalie trying to fend off all the kids.
Trying to
see what's on the stove.
Man, buddy.
Yeah, you can't take your eye off of them, especially at those ages.
Oof-ta.
If a stove fire does happen in your kitchen, here's what you should do. Don't use water to put out the flames. Instead, turn the burner off and then use another pan and place it on top of the pan. That'll smother the flames. Instead of the water can splash the oil that may be on fire or the fire around the kitchen and make a bigger problem. So instead, smother the flames with another pan.
I didn't know that. Learn something new today.
There you go.
Okay, today is your last day for a chance to win a pair of News 3 Now coffee mugs.
This is it. Two more mugs left. All you got to do is go to our website, answer this question of the day. Do you buy a real Christmas tree?
Chris does, I do. Mr. Reese does not. No. But that's okay. Yes or no, you still get entered for a chance to win. Our final day, folks. Turn it in.
All right, head to channel3000.com/contest to play. This is the last day, folks. It's been a lot of fun. Hopefully we can bring this back and do some more mugs.
Yeah, absolutely.
Another time.
6:50 now. Coming up in the morning sprint, all of the morning stop stories.
First, though, we want to say happy birthday to
Lorelai.
And all the kiddos turning 3 today. Thanks for celebrating with us. We'll be right back.
The Amy Awards, reaching higher. Monday night at 6:30. Beat the clock to the biggest Black Friday sale ever at Furniture and Appliance Mart. Save up to 42% off top brand appliances. Plus special no-interest financing. Doors open at 8 a.m. Friday. Only at Furniture and Appliance Mart inside Ashley Home Store off the Beltline. It's Menards' last 11% rebate sale of 2021. And now is a great time to update the floors in your home. Vinyl plank flooring is perfect for active lifestyles. It's durable, waterproof, and easy to install. Whatever your style, we carry the vinyl plank flooring for you. Finish your flooring projects before the holidays and save 11% on all vinyl plank flooring now during Menards' last 11% rebate sale of 2021.
Save big money at Menards.
Precision engineering, rigorous attention to detail. A Bryant Evolution heating system is so well designed, it's as much of a joy to install as it is to use.
Good to go.
Bryant, whatever it takes.
In the Fitchburg area, contact Tarkenton Brothers Heating, Ventilating, and Air Conditioning for quality comfort solutions.
I matched with this cutie on a dating site. We texted all the time, but never met up. Then he asked to send him gift cards for a plane ticket to see me. And that's when I remembered a tip I got from the AARP Fraud Watch Network. Gift cards. This is a romance scam. Spent that money on self-care instead.
Recognize fraud sooner so your money lives longer. The younger you are, the more you need AARP.
Hey, guys.
Hey, Dad.
You ready?
This holiday, U.S. Cellular is doing a little something extra to keep everyone connected. Right now, choose any phone from any brand at any of our stores for free. Plus, save big with unlimited data for our best price of the season, just $30 a month. Now that's a deal to cheer about. Feel the locally grown joy from U.S. Cellular, America's locally grown wireless.
Happy holidays from Meineke Car Care Center. We would like to thank you for your business this year and wish you and your family a safe and happy holiday season. Drive safe during all of your travels. Meineke, doing car care right.
Even the smallest surprise can make a big memory worthy of passing on. Kinder Joy, treat plus new holiday toys. A little surprise goes a long way.
Beat the clock to the biggest Black Friday sale ever at Ashley Home Store. Doors open at 8 a.m. Save up to 65% off doorbusters and special deals. Plus, take up to a bonus 20% off our sale prices Friday only. Beat the clock starting at 8 a.m. Friday at Ashley Home Store.
Keep an eye on your eyes. SSM Health.
6:53, time for the morning sprint.
More charges expected for the man responsible for the deadly incident at Waukesha's parade this week. 39-year-old Daryl Brooks will face 6 counts of intentional homicide following the death of another victim, an 8-year-old boy. More than 60 were injured. His bail is set at $5 million.
Pope Francis offering up prayers for the victims and families affected by the tragedy. The Vatican says he issued a telegram yesterday. In it, he writes that he's praying for God to bestow upon everyone the spiritual strength which triumphs over violence and overcomes evil with good. A Catholic priest and a Catholic school child were among those injured.
SpaceX firing a small NASA probe into space overnight aimed at a distant asteroid. It sets up a head-on 15,000-mile-an-hour impact next September. They're finding out if it's capable of nudging a threatening body off course if one thing like this ever approached Earth. The project, known as DART, is a historic $330 million mission.
Opening weekend of the annual gun deer hunt in Wisconsin, down compared to last year. The DNR says hunters shot more than 85,000 deer the first couple days. That is about 14,000 fewer than the first 2 days in 2020. In Dane County, 942 deer were harvested. Officials say they responded to 3 reported shootings over the weekend, too. Everyone survived.
Dane County residents will have to keep their masks on through at least January 3rd. The order was originally set to expire on Saturday. Health officials point to rising COVID cases as the reason they decided to extend it. They say a large percentage of kids may be fully vaccinated by the new year, allowing them to let the order expire.
A family attorney says Brian Laundrie died by suicide from a gunshot wound to the head. Laundrie vanished days after his fiancee, Gabby Petito, went missing on a cross-country road trip. His remains were found last month in Florida. Petito's body was recovered in September in Wyoming. Her death ruled a homicide by strangulation. Laundrie considered a person of interest in the case, but never charged with Petito's death.
3 pharmaceutical chains say they plan to appeal after a jury found them responsible for part of the opioid epidemic. The defendants in the civil case are CVS, Walmart, and Walgreens. The ruling could set a precedent for other lawsuits nationally. It's unclear how much money the judge will decide the companies have to pay.
51, that's the expected high today, but a lot of us are going to spend time in the 40s, and we will briefly touch 51 degrees. That likely happens sometime between 12 and 4 o'clock. Notice how most of the day, though, you see a 4 in front of whatever number you have. 37 right now. The cloud cover is on the increase as winds stay out of the south. Here's the next 12 hours when it comes to temperature. We'll likely reach 40s by about 9 o'clock. We'll stay there until about 3 before falling back in.
Chris Reese, thank you. And thanks for joining us this morning, folks. Have a happy Thanksgiving with your family. We'll see you back here Friday morning.